What's the first thing that comes to your mind when you think of electric motorcycles? Let me guess. Slow, boring, and dorky, right? Well, what if I told you that this perception of ours is outdated? What if I told you that an electric motorcycle recently whooped the ass of 82 petrol-powered superbikes by a margin of 20 seconds to win the Peak Spike International Hill Climb? So now that we are up to speed with the massive strides that electric motorcycles have made over the last few years, slow isn't exactly the word I would use to describe Tork India's first ever street-based prototype. As you can see, this bike has been built around Yamaha's highly successful FZ16 platform. And this is actually a bolt-on design. And I'm not joking when I say so, because if you're willing, your FZ can go from petrol power to electric in a matter of just 4 hours. That's how beautifully simple and clean this design is. And the electric motor just mounts on directly, acting as a stress member. So it's not just very well thought out, it's the way it's been put together. And this is what it sounds like. That is a byproduct of going green. You don't just lose out on the smoke, you lose out on the sound as well. So despite tipping the scales up to about 150 kgs, 0 to 100 is dispatched in are you serious? Do you see?
Yeah.
Okay, so this bike right here, this electric motor, this electric power, I'm so overwhelmed. Okay, whew. This electric bike has just set a 0 to 100 timing of 8.7 seconds.
If you see all the manufacturers like Yamaha, Suzuki, Honda, they test their vehicles on racetrack, on MotoGP platform, and then from there, a little of that technology is taken on the roads. So this is what we wanted to do.
As there are no gears, there's no engine braking. And that leaves you completely at the mercy of the stock brake setup of the FZ. And they instill the same amount of fear in you as the exhilaration you feel when you open the throttle to the stop.
Yamaha FZ 150 is the largest selling 150 motorcycle in India. It is also sold in major countries like Colombia, Malaysia, Indonesia, and other parts of Europe and some other countries also. So making a kit for this motorcycle would mean that we can also export these kits to other countries also. Plus, all the motorcycles in India have a similar frame. So if I can make an electric kit for an FZ, I can almost make electric kits for 90% of Indian motorcycles. And if you look at the numbers, the torque is about 16 Newton meters. But when you start the bike, the power delivery is a little linear, because all this torque tends to break away the inertia first, and from 40 onwards, it just flies.
So the placement of the batteries above the electric motor has lifted the center of gravity of the bike. But I still thought this was just as nimble and flickable as a stock FZ. The weight transfer on this, when you're on and off the throttle, is very, very smooth. And the second part, which is the best part, is when you are gunning the bike at the corner exits, because the 16 Newton meters of torque, you get it as soon as you twist the throttle. You would want to ride this thing for a really long time, because that's how much fun it is. But if you're the kind of guy who likes to keep the motor on the boil, well, this bike has a very limited range as of now, because riding like that, it only takes you to about 40 odd kilometers, while a sedate, nice, relaxed ride, about 70 odd. And then there's the price.
The drivetrain itself will cost you about 3.8 lakhs, but 65% of that cost will come from the batteries. Today we buy them at the half the price we used to buy in 2007. So by the next 2 years, we'll have a better battery, a cheaper battery, and a longer range.
There are still a lot of changes which will be made to improve the efficiency, to improve the range. And this is a very nascent market that we have here in India, where electric bikes have been frowned upon. But this bike is going to change that because this clearly burns past the slow, dreary image of the electric bikes. This is quick. This is a lot of fun.
So we don't want to take that fun factor away from a motorcycle. We want everything of a motorcycle to remain intact.